Hello and welcome to a new tutorial. In this quick tutorial, I'll show you a simple way to start an Alembic animation. In this sample, the animation starts at frame 0 as usual. When we play it, you see our character is making her move immediately. If we change the start of animation, it will start at this frame instead of frame 0. Like this. Yes. We can use some keyframes to start an animation in our projects, but this is not a good way to do nice things. Keyframes are not flexible. We should use triggers to activate the movements or animations at the desired frame. The triggers must be flexible, depend on our scene actions. Now we need an Xpresso tag to make things better and easy. Just do this. In Xpresso, there are many ways to trigger the actions. Collision, ray collision, distance, or dynamic collision. All these use as triggers. But in our scene, we will not use them. We use an object's position to trigger and start the animation. In this example, we use the Z position of a little stage to start the animation. We should decide which position is good for starting point. The stage sits on the floor and the Z position is 0. Moving from here, we can say that if the stage's Z position is greater than 0, the animation will start.
Just put the stage object into the Xpresso editor and select the global position Z. Now, a compare node is required to check the position Z. If the position is greater than 0, the compare node returns 1. Otherwise, it returns 0. Okay, we do something if the compare node gives 1. When the desired condition occurs, we need to freeze time, and this should be the frame where the animation will start. How will we compare the value we have frozen with? Of course, with the timeline value. Now we need another compare node to compare if the timeline value and the freeze value same or not. If the freeze time is different from the current time, it means that the desired condition has been met. So we should select the not operator from list. This is the time to put the Alembic file in scene. We will use its start of animation slot to give a desired value. The animation will start or not, or when it will start. Now we can use a condition node. The condition node has some slots, and depend on its switch value, it decides which slot will be active and which value will be used as output. The value from the compare node must connect to the switch slot. This will give the value of 1 or 0 depend on the conditions. As you see, the input 2 will have a value if switch is 0. If the switch will have value of 1, it goes to the input 3. We can put some values by hand, but we don't do this. The values should occur automatically depending on the situation. 0 means that the trigger is not true yet. So the animation should never start. So we can put the last frame of timeline to the input 2. For this, we can use the time node's end function. So if the trigger is true, in other words, if the stage's Z position is greater than 0, we can give the freeze value to input 3 as the starting frame. Now let's try this. You see that start of animation indicates frame 600. This is the last frame in timeline. Even if we expand the timeline, it returns to new value. like 900. Everything is ready now, just try if it works or not. Yeah, you see if the stage's Z position is greater than 0, the animation starts at this frame. Whenever you move the stage, the animation starts again and again. You decide not to move the stage? Okay, you wait forever. Looks like this girl will never get tired of jumping. Yes, folks. I hope I was able to explain the issue well. Thanks for watching. See you later.